North America is arguably one of the strongest regions in esports.
Texas Open, these misfits push themselves straight into the quarterfinals, and there it is!
And EU beats NA on the day.
North America is the home of many local talents that dominate the foreign opposition.
Up is going to miss. Flair's getting some damage, Zoki. He split across on the far side. Can they lock
it? Oh, he does a flash!
North America has the most skilled players that can execute flawless plays without fail.
But the positioning is really good. They have double Trinity Force poke. Holy shit. You have to be kidding me. Just throw it here. What are you doing? This is so easy. I could do this.
Welcome to NA, the home of champions in esports.
The Nexus is going down, and Team Solo Mid, their hopes, their dreams, they're done! Royal advance to Chicago!
NA is usually playing catch-up to Korea, China, and even EU in esports. This doesn't mean that NA never achieves anything. NA teams have garnered major titles over the years. Team Liquid won TI7, Evil Geniuses in TI5, and NA CSGO teams have taken home many majors over the years. But long story short, NA loses often internationally on average. It's the harsh reality. As a result, NA has become a moniker for any play that is bad or laughable in esports. Although most of the bashing seems to come from NA itself, which is kind of ironic to me. Let's see how this came to be. There's no clear origin as to where NA was used first as a derogatory moniker, but it is safe to assume that League of Legends played a big role in the growth of the term. Being one of the biggest esports in North America, NA had high hopes to become the number one region in the world in League of Legends. But sadly, NA has yet to win a world championship or hold a positive win ratio over Korean or Chinese teams, who are the dominant region at the moment. Combine the winless streak at international tournaments and home to amazing plays like this.
1,000 gold, but somehow have the aggression, somehow have TSM on the
back. Missed it!
They completely missed Crescendo and the flash.
Holy shit.
NA became somewhat of a laughingstock for a region that failed to get a return for its bountiful resources. Oop, did I just say that out loud? Much like Jalok, the player doesn't necessarily need to be from NA for the play to be labeled as an NA insert play here. Because if it's bad, it's NA. The most commonly used version of NA anything is NA alt. But since this term applies to any game, you can pretty much add anything to it to make it an NA lol meme. Literally, adding the ultimates from Overwatch alone gives it 28 different variations of NA anything. It is infinite possibilities. Coming back to Overwatch, NA alt is most commonly used NA moniker, as ultimates decide the outcome of a teamfight or even a match. Hence, you will find many NA alts in the Overwatch League, as pros are not exempt from the fate that is the NA lol. That's it for this video. Hopefully we'll hear some good news from NA from various World Cups happening later this year.
And it looks like the fourth curse is finally lifted from Team Liquid with all of the streaks of success that you guys have had. And just wondering, is this the best iteration of Team Liquid that we've ever seen?
Absolutely. You know, we did it in Dota. We're gonna do it in League. Our eyes are set on a world championship. So that's the fucking goal.
We will now end this video off with a tribute to NA alts in the Overwatch League. Thank you for watching.
You know, something cool. You can kind of you can get Custer.
So that's the second time in the series you've seen
bloody hell.
Fire King gets boot there using his sound barriers to only connect with himself and altering. It'll be the Death Blossom user.
Dallas pushing forward. There's a grab now on the Houston side. Transcendence right away from Unko. Dragon Strike goes through.
Another rally for Mickey. The blade comes in though. Might be the only hope for London here.
What is this? How does Unko live through that?
Of the fuel has been depleted. And he's gonna have to get out himself. It's 50% to 5 here on our second stage of the poll.
And Custa actually used the Transcendence there towards the end.
The Stakes tried to swap to the Junkrat, but he's dead already. Transcendence used for Aimgout as they try to go in Harry Hook with that Valkyrie. Earthshatter. The Blade like immediately, because Boombox is gonna have that trance soon. Blade coming in just in time here. Liberal trying to find the targets, getting pushed back though by Hotbutt. And he's gonna get run.
See if he decides to use it. He is pretty charged up. There's the Graviton Surge.
Pretty charged up. You mean the spaceship might have had a big impact, but
Reluctix?
Playing a little bit more Sombra throughout Overwatch League.
What's up, Bim?
Hey, how's it going, guys? Looking good back there.
Oh, hey.
What's up? Do you have Gesture and London sitting up top on the high ground here? They're trying to push on through.
Yeah,
there we go.
That you just saw that be used, and here you go.
Dragon Strike coming through, but they didn't really catch a whole lot of people with that one. Nobody goes down to the combo, and now the Earthshatter comes in, gets blocked by Fearless. But man, that would be insane.
And there's this Dragon Strike. Space was dead, but they could have saved it. They could have saved it for Space's ultimate.
Earthshatter does not do anything to Fate, really.
And Harry Hook, and with Mickey down, that's even less healing. The Blade's gonna come in, look for targets, and find out. There was a self-destruct. He is looking for the kill here. Diamond is here on Flash. Doesn't look like he has the
We've seen it in the past here from EQ. The hero Blades. Yep, he spotted his target right off the Harry Hook immediately.
Go!